I would love to see another return for a game, for a stage like this, or a style of gameplay like this in Sonic Mania, since that game is still being made right. What is up, guys? Super 321s, and you back to an episode of Sonic Generations. In the last episode, we completed both Chemical Plant Zone and Green Hill Zone. And if you guys are enjoying the series, make sure to leave a like. And yeah, let's actually get started in the game. We are going to Sky Sanctuary Zone. One of the zones that have like the most amazing remixes next to Chemical Plant Zone. Just listen to this. So, Chemical Plant Zone. Wow, I cannot talk. So we're going to go around, collect some of the red rings here, but Sky Sanctuary Zone, I like the gameplay style for it. It's like a big reboot from the original. Wow, my controller is malfunctioning. But yeah, the music is so amazing. It's so cool. I just like it. Like, when we get to a certain part, I'll let you guys listen to it, but literally. Okay, my control is a little bit buggy right now, but you want to go to the left here to go and get this red ring. I think you want to go ahead to the right to go on the upper path. And I think this is actually one of the stages where you can actually get the red ring very early right now. Well, in one shot. All you have to do is just go around here, get these. No! Oh, are you kidding me right now? Oh, what? Hold on, no, I don't count that. That was malarkey. That was horrible, that was crap. But Sky Sanctuary Zone is pretty cool, pretty amazing. I would love to see another return for a game, for a stage like this, or a style of gameplay like this, in Sonic Mania, since that game is still being made right. Are we really doing this right now? I got a game over! What? I literally got a game over! Oh my, I just died right, oh my god, something inside of me just died. This game is mad easy, and I got a game over. Oh my god, what is wrong with me? Alright, but anyways, just get the red ring right there. I'm probably going to cut back until I, get back to the little area. Or not. I'm actually really close to the area. But yo! I literally got a game over! Oh my god, what the heck's happened? Wow. Okay, don't get hit. Get that red ring, and you want to stay on the top path right here. I love the fast-paced Sonic. Boost the wind stages are not really my forte. I don't remember where I'm supposed to go here for the red ring, so I'm just going to take this pathway right here. And I failed! Oh my god! Oh, okay, so I think the red ring's just like right up here. Or not. I promise you guys, I'm not this bad. Okay, this is the part that's coming up. This is the amazing soundtrack and stuff. Like, I love this. Listen to this. That little section right there when it goes like up to the high note, I love it. It's amazing. I love the, I don't know if it's the orchestra or anything. Music is also not my forte. Well, it kinda isn't. But just, yeah, so let me just get up here. I want to take the top path because there's going to be another red ring here, which I think is going to be the last one. So right here, you need to beat this robot to this section right here. So take the bottom path. Or not. Wait, where's the last red ring then? I'm lost. Oh, what? My homing attack! It didn't come out right! I'm not taking... Why am I taking so many L's right now? So... Don't know where the last red ring is. That is a problem. That is a problem. I don't know where the last red ring was. I'm gonna go find it after I'm done with the Classic Sonic version of this, but to see what we get. We get the artwork, more, and more. Oh wait, I got all of them. Oh, okay, Gage Rooter. Okay, so I don't have Okay, so this is the one where you can't really just, you know, just go through the stage and collect all the red rings in one try. So let's go to the classic version of this. I'm doing it in this order because you get a fun cutscene out of this, doing it this order. Because if you do not know, every time you get the, like, area return back to normal, you get a little cutscene, and like, the last Sonic you play the area with, you get a cutscene for that specific Sonic. So there's the first red ring. You can get at least 3 red rings in this area at one time. Well, you can get up to 3 red rings at one time during the first playthrough of the stage. And we will go over that, well, as soon as we get to the end of the stage here. But anyways, Sky Sanctuary Zone, we have like pretty much the same music. I missed that. We pretty much have the same music for this. We use a treasure tracker right here, for example of that. It does a little ringer right here, so you know if you're near like a little collectible or anything. But yeah. But yeah, the music for the classic parts right here is pretty much the same. Just a little bit of the remixes there, but not all of it. Okay, I wanted to take that speed boost, but okay. Oh, wow. Okay, something is really wrong with my controls right now. Like, is that the control? Is that the game controls? It's just my controller. It's just messing up a little bit. Again, this is the last time I'm buying a controller from Walmart. But anyways, let's go through this area right here. There's going to be another red ring. I think it's supposed to be the third red ring you're supposed to get, but I messed up somewhere. But anyways, you want to go up to the top path to get this invincibility. And there's another pathway up there, but since I'm not going up there now, I guess we can continue through the bottom path. But anyways, I think we're getting close to the end right there. So yeah, what I'm talking about, like how you can get up to like at most 3 red rings during your first playthrough of this stage. So basically, there are different pathways you can take. Basically 3 off-point pathways. You're always going to get a red ring at the end of the stage, no matter what. If you intentionally miss it, there's no way to actually dodge this last red ring coming up. Unless you're actually really good at dodging everything in Sonic. But if it's your first playthrough to the stage, then you probably already know that it's really unavoidable right at this point. Unless you know any other tricks and tips that I don't know, but anyways, just get up here. Should probably start talking. But anyways, go up here, and then, yeah, platforms will fall apart, and then take the middle road, which leads to one of the red rings, and I actually did not miss any red ring, but now we have to go take a different pathway to go and get these red rings. So yeah, I'm gonna go back into these stages to get those red rings. So, if I go to... So, I'm going to cut back when I show a different pathway, but here is cutscene.
Thanks, Sonic. You did a good job back there. Hey, did you gain weight? Sonic.
I love that cutscene. Thanks for the assist, Sonic. I hope everything else is alright, too. But now, since we completed these stages here, we get to access the Chaos Emeralds and the little gate challenge gates you get for every time you complete one, every time you complete all the stages. There's 10 in each zone, 5 for each character, well, 5 for each Sonic in each zone. And I think there's a total of 260 of these. I am going to show them on camera, but not all of them. I'm going to show all the friend ones and all the new techniques you get. And we get music for the Mushroom Hill Zone. But anyways, I'm going to meet you guys back when I get those different pathways to find those red rings. So yeah. Ooh, okay, clutch. Okay, so here you go. Out to the top pathway. Go here. And then you get to this alternate route right here, which takes you to the path on the far left of the stage when I get there. So I'm just going to keep this part in right here. You guys don't really have to hear me talk a lot this time, but just let you know, that's how you get up there. You just gotta make it up to the way I had trouble with. Do not fall. And you should be good. And if you guys haven't noticed much, that I haven't actually taken the pathway that used a little spin top thing. So yeah, if you're using the little spin top thing, then you're probably going on the bottom or the very bottom pathway. Okay, so here we go. Oh, the one on the far right this time. So now, we go on a different pathway to show the other one. Alright, so I think this part right down here will take me to the bottom path if I do things correctly. So don't take the, don't take this, just go down here. And I was wrong about this, you want to go down here. Up to the same pathway that takes me with the spring. I don't recognize if I'm going the same or wrong way, I just... Am I going the bottom way? I think I am. Okay, so I think this is the most left pathway of all. And I've gotten the last red ring. So I was going the bottom pathway, I was just getting confused. And I got artwork 25, and the song, It Doesn't Matter! I love this song! It doesn't matter. Ooh, but now, we meet with our old friend. Hey, let's go. I love this thing. Battle Metal Sonic. So I never played the 3DS version of this game, but here we go. The cutscene for Metal Sonic. I'm gonna talk because there's no important cutscenes here with talking and stuff. Get to see a little action scene with Sonic and Metal Sonic. Instead of that pimp slap, we get that pimp bounce. But yeah, I love this battle very much. It's the reason why I really wanted to play Sonic CD for the Road to Sonic Mania. And this is the battle with Metal Sonic. A remix battle with Metal Sonic. You can attack Metal Slime from behind him when he's doing a little spin attack, or when he runs out and like starts smoke, giving off some smoke. You can attack him then. And there's one more place where you can attack him now, but I want to sit. Yeah, okay, I got some eggs. Okay, thank you, Uma Chow, for explaining this boss fight for me. I really appreciate that waste of my voice and advice. Metal Slime needs about like 4 or 5 hits to defeat, so I'm just gonna show off some attacks right now. So now he's gonna show like a little big Mega Linger. So now there's gonna be platforms that show up, so you have to go on the top pad right here, skip his attack, and then he's gonna try to catch up with you, and then there's a chance for you to hit him right here, and you're just gonna end the boss fight, I think. So now just time this jump right, and there we go. That's the boss fight. Very easy boss fight. We gave him, it's some scrap metal right there. S rank, and I'm actually getting so close to obtaining that S rank achievement, but we get our first Chaos Emerald. Legend says causing all seven will cause mysterious power to emerge. I'm sorry for my bad English. It happens every once in a while. But I think I have enough time for some more gameplay. So, right now, for the rest of this video, I'm going to play about like one or two of the challenge gates for each of the Sonic. The first one is going to be the Doppelganger one. First of all, we can go ahead and change the music. I'm going to go with the original Green Hill Zone music. So let's go. Basically, this is simple. I probably might skip this because I'm just going to show this once. But you can have the Doppelganger race. Basically, you race against another a computer-built Sonic challenge to race you. I am definitely going to disable Uma Chow for the next episode. He's annoying! But yeah, Doppelganger race is very simple. Just speed through the stage right here. And you should be good. Now there's an achievement you can be in this stage, which is to beat this whole entire level under a minute. I've done it before, I got the achievement for it. It's very simple. All you have to do is just spam spin dashes at any straightaway you go, like this one. And you should be good. So now, the stage is basically almost completed. I just gotta beat it before it hits a minute. Come on. Come on. Come on. I'm not gonna make it. I'm not gonna make it. Dang it! Well, I won. But that's the Doppelganger race. Basically, play through the stage over again. And that's it. And now, since a bonus spell has been added, this is how you get extra music and stuff. And artwork. So I'm gonna get that key. You need 3 keys to advance. So now I'm gonna show you the races. Not only is there a Doppelganger race, but there's also first one to the finish wins. A race against your friends. There's gonna be races, there's gonna be challenges, and there can also be support missions. Right now I'm doing a race mission, which shows all the missions for this stuff. All the race mission where you race against Knuckles, Tails, and any other character like that. This one, and you guys can hear in the background, there's a remix for Super Sonic Racing, which I will beat myself for right now. Not yet. Okay. I love that soundtrack so much. I love the original, and I love the soundtrack now. Super Sonic Racing is actually one of the most known songs for each of these, and I'm actually close to getting an S rank. I did not want to get that A-ring. You saw how close that was too, right? I'm going to attempt to make an A-ring, I mean, an S-ring on all these missions right here. But now we get the thing for Splash Hill Zone. But now I'm going to choose two for this one. But yeah, basically the next episode is going to be all about the these little challenge gates. I'm probably going to do all of them, so it's going to be a pretty long episode next time. But yeah, I think I want to do this one. So it's going to be this one and the Tails one. I'm going to end up episode right there. But the 300% boost gauge. This is a skill you can unlock at the skill gate. But yeah, this is what happens. So I think this is a skill you can get in the shop. And basically you get this conserve your boost gauge because it will not refill at all after you use this. But yeah, the games will give you like extra skills and stuff for the challenge and stuff. So just be careful of what you're doing and you should be good. I'm gonna do as I do as always and try to get an S-Ring on this. I don't know how far I have to get an S-Ring on this. But yeah. Let's put my Sonic skills to the test. And let's hope I can do this. And there you go! Success. Or succeeded. And now, for the last mission I'm going to do for this episode, is going to be... There we go, we can buy ourselves a new skill. But the last mission I'm going to do for this episode is this one. Which is the Way Past Fast Challenge, which is another race for against Tails. And you get to hear more supersonic racing music, so let's go ahead and do this. I don't know why, but I find this mission a little bit hard because Tails is using a plane and Sonic's just running on the floor. I have to find alternate pathways, so this is actually very unfair. But hey. I have skills, so let's put them to the test. I'm saying that right now, but I have like no skills whatsoever. And there we go. That's it for the missions. Get this little skill right here. Toxic Caves. And let's go to the shop real quick. Because I want the boost gauge up. But I think the difference between this one and the challenge is that your boost gauge will refill. I might be wrong about this, but... Yeah, I'm just going to buy the rest of these skills right here. You guys can pause the video to read this, but right now I'm just going to get that. And I think this is going to be it for this episode. Hope you guys did enjoy this episode of Sonic Generations. If you guys did enjoy this, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next episode. Next time, we will be continuing more of these special challenges and getting ready for the boss fight. But real quick. I'll see you all in the next episode. Peace out, my gamers!